Good afternoon and welcome to this short validity function. I am told that the workshop has gone well, rather rigorous as I personally found out when I have gone to the Goa remote center and as some of my colleagues have visited some other remote centers. Well, of course, I do not know whether the feedback has been collected or it has yet to come. It is being collected. Administratively, I would like to reiterate that we have decided that no certificate will be issued unless you have put in your feedback. Please remember that the feedback is anonymous, so we do not know what is said by whom if you so choose, but we definitely know whether every faculty member attending this workshop has given the feedback or not. That is recorded in any case. So kindly give the feedback. You would recall that I had mentioned that this is first of the new series of workshops where we now have the mandate from the ministry to try and train up to 10,000 teachers in a single subject. This time we attempted to scale up. We had about 167 remote centers. We will increase this number in future for the other courses. We will also be setting up some nodal centers so that the interaction between the participants at the remote centers and the experts at these nodal centers could be perhaps more intense than what is feasible when you scale up to this magnitude. Most important point is that in a very fundamental course such as thermodynamics, more than 5,600 teachers have enthusiastically participated, and my request to all of you would be that please add to whatever expertise you yourself have, please add to whatever teaching methodology that you have been following, please add to your expertise and your methodology, whatever additional useful points that you find from this workshop, and try to enhance the quality of teaching that you will undertake in coming years when you deal with these students. I am tempted to repeat once again the main point that in today's 4-year syllabus framework, the basic engineering courses suffer for two reasons. One, the numbers have been reduced and therefore the coverage has been reduced, and two, students increasingly tend to neglect those subjects which are not perceived as directly relevant to their own field of study. I have seen this to be particularly true with computer science students, but I think this would generally be true about other students as well. It is all the more important therefore that when you teach your students, tell them that fundamental subjects such as thermodynamics have no caste or creed like this discipline or that discipline. They are just fundamentally important subjects connecting physics with engineering. I am sure that you would have now decided upon the assignment that you will be doing as a team. Teams have been formed already, I guess. Professor Gayathonde has been quite enthusiastic about trying to introduce new models of assignment like preparing spoken tutorials, and that could be a very, very important and useful contribution. This is something, by the way, which was never feasible to be made part of any reference material in conventional course. So, because spoken tutorials cannot be printed in a book and cannot be read from a printed material, you need modern technology for that. Most of our remote centers are also our Akash project partners, and they will be attempting to use Akash for teaching some of their subjects. I am sure that some teachers from these colleges who are participating might want to teach thermodynamics either in the coming semester or in the semester starting with July using Akash tablets. I would encourage you to think like that, and I will make sure that not by January but by July time frame every remote center college would have sufficient number of Akash tablets to try and teach courses of such fundamental importance. But do, please do take the team assignment very seriously, and don't forget that whatever you do will be released in open source, and therefore you have to not only ensure that the quality of the work that you submit is good and is appreciated to be good by others all over the world who will see it, but very particularly avoid even a remote chance of somebody accusing us of plagiarizing some material from some source without any appropriate credit being given to that. Finally, before I hand over mic to the coordinator and his colleague faculties here, I would like to suggest that the colleges that you come from, and most of you will not belong to the remote center colleges themselves, you will be coming from different institutions. Please try to suggest to other colleague teachers in your colleges that in future when we conduct the remaining 14 workshops over the next 3 years, many of them teaching different subjects might want to benefit from this endeavor. Although we have a slightly different funding model, because this time the government has said that since the scale is large, we will be restricting certain expenses. Still, overall, there is a substantial support available for conducting these workshops and for participating in these workshops. So I hope to see more and more of you and your other colleagues coming forward to benefit from these workshop models. I must also compliment the workshop coordinators at these respective remote centers, who for 2 weeks have been coordinating the activities of the workshop. You will all agree that it's not an easy job. They have to do a lot of work there, maintaining even the infrastructure, technical infrastructure working correctly, right, like audio and video connections or the internet connections, the Moodle. I understand that there were some Moodle problems when you people gave the test. Yes, so I wanted to assure you that in summer when we conduct the exercise, we will most likely be moving Moodle out of our own proxy servers setup, so that there will be no scaling problem in future. In any case, I think both the participants and the remote center coordinators are to be complimented to have overcome these small glitches and have made this workshop successful. And of course, last but not the least, there are 2 sets of people in IIT Bombay itself whom I must compliment. First is our team here, the workshop team. Can you just, there are some of them at least here. Not all, but some. So anyway, whatever numbers you see here, at least 3 times as many are working in the back end labs and so on. So thank you very much for helping us to conduct this workshop properly. And finally, the 3 faculty members who agreed to take this step. Please remember that when we said we'll conduct this mega workshop of 10,000 teachers, we had no approval from the ministry to conduct it. So we had a lot of problems. What would happen if the sanction does not come in time and so on? And yet Professor Gayatonde, Professor Bhandarkar and Professor Puranik agreed to take this step and prepared accordingly, and they have delivered. So thank you very much. The good news is that the formal sanction letter from the ministry for extension of this program has been issued not exactly before the course began, but before the course ended. The letter is dated 20th of December, which was exactly 1 day before the course end. So whatever we have done has the formal approval of the ministry, not just for expenditure, but for our certification program from IST and so on. So I think all is well, that ends well. I will conclude by once again thanking profusely Professor Gayatonde, Professor Bhandarkar, Professor Purani. So let me at least shake hands with you for doing a marvelous job. Thank you. Thank you very much. May I request my colleague professors to say a few words in conclusions.
So I would like to thank everyone who made this possible. So I am still I'm still not that conversant with thermodynamics to answer the variety of questions that Professor Gaitonde is able to answer. And but however, with hopefully with more practice, I would be able to get myself more absorbed in this. So I would say that these small lectures that I have taken have really helped me also, because I do try my best to prepare much better, and in during these preparations I definitely learn something new each time, and this has been a good learning experience for me, and I hope that people do put in effort when they teach their students, so that students can ask various types of questions, and it's not always very easy to answer all these questions. And what it makes us do is that we go back and try to figure out what is being said, whether this makes sense, and always try to come up with better and better answers. And during that process, each time we learn something, and I think that is something that I would probably ask all of you to do, that each time you teach, try to make the course new and different, and even learn something new each time, and you will realize during the course of time that you have learned quite a lot. So this is all I have to say, because finally all of you are teachers, and maybe this is something that I have been trying to do all this time, and I hope you can do the same too, and ensure that the students feel that something good is being taught, or some reasonable amount of stuff is being taught. So that is my all that I had to say. So I'll just pass on the mic now. Thank you.
Yeah, actually I would like to thank Professor Gaitonde and Patak. I'm not really a thermodynamics person, but fortunately Professor Gaitonde realized that, I suppose, and he asked me to handle a very small part that too is not really a thermodynamics per se part, as some people can say. In any case, I have similar comments to what Professor Bhandarkar has said. It's been a good learning experience for all of us. This is the second workshop that I am involved in, and even in the first workshop, which happened about 6 months back, it was again exactly the same sort of an experience, in the sense that while delivering these lectures and interacting with participants, we end up learning sufficient amount, and I can right away tell you that while the interactions were going on over the last 2 or 3 days, I have already come up with a few new ideas for problems in my next semester's class. So I would like to thank some of the participants whose questions have prompted those ideas, and this is precisely what we would like to convey, in my opinion, that you have to constantly keep thinking about this this subject. Hardly ever it is going to happen that you attend a workshop or attend a course and you think that you have understood sufficient amount of it. It never happens. So what we have to do is we keep going back to the same material again and again, and try to think it in different fashions. In doing so, invariably you will go through different books, and one thing about through different books is that different flavors or ideas conveyed by different people, you can try to put together in your own world, and eventually what happens is it helps in delivering a class lecture once you have gone through these things. So my suggestion and request to you is that a very large amount of material has been transferred to you over these last 10 days, and quite honestly, I don't expect that everyone will be sufficiently comfortable with this kind of material. The only way to get comfortable with this material is to, again, as I said, keep going back and keep working on it. So in that sense, I would like to wish you all the best, and hopefully you will be able to incorporate as much material as you can from these past 10 days in your courses. So thank you, and thanks for an excellent interaction.
So after 10 days of interaction, the final interaction, first a vote of thanks from my side, and then some instructions. The instructions will never end. First thing, I should thank Professor Patak for personally putting his confidence in me in being able to teach thermodynamics again within 2 years over 10 days. And again, the ease with which my colleagues Bhandarkar and Puranik agreed to be a part of this. I know that when I took the poll, they were wishing that hardly anyone would pick these up, but there was a reasonable response. The only topic which got deleted or was not included was kinetic theory. Then I think I myself agreed to do this again for one major reason, and that reason is the environment which is made available to us for conducting these courses. We are teachers, we are technical people, I think only of thermodynamics when I teach thermodynamics, and all the other admin related activities are taken care of by the excellent team created by Professor Patak and his colleagues. After having said so, I would say that there are my own colleagues, apart from Bhandarkar and Puranik, who have directly or indirectly have helped me out. And finally, I should go back in time and I should acknowledge the contribution of a large number of my teachers, both of thermodynamics and others, who have helped me reach this stage in the understanding of thermodynamics, where I can make a reasonably neat effort in trying to explain thermodynamics to other college teachers. I would prefer not to list names because the names are too many, but there are a few who have directly contributed to my understanding and the learning process as well as the teaching process of thermodynamics. The direct teachers of thermodynamics and applied thermodynamics were Professors Sundar Rajan and Viladkar from the Department of Physics, and Professors Achyutan, Sukhatme, Jagdish and Jagan Mohan from the Department of Mechanical Engineering, and also Professor Dinkar D. Deshpande of Physical Chemistry of IIT Bombay. All of them have retired. Some of them are no more with us, but I think their contribution I should acknowledge every time I teach thermodynamics to any group of people. There are other teachers, for example, Professor Vartak of Mathematics. From him I learned how to use the board in a very, very disciplined way. And Professor Parulekar of Mechanical Engineering, who taught me refrigeration, how to sketch simple figures as you talk to students on the board. Simple figures, just go on modifying them one small bit at a time. This is what I learned from Professor Parulekar. After having said so, let me say I should thank all of you for participating, but this participation has been made possible by my TA team, the 5 students which you see here. They are all students of mechanical engineering. One of them is the blue shirted person, Ratan, right? He is in second year, just finished learning his thermodynamics from my colleagues. The other three here, that is Akshit Markan, Debat Jyoti Nandi, and Bansal Shah. They are my students last year of thermodynamics, and I am happy that
even after the course is over, they don't hate thermodynamics anymore and we're more than willing to help out with the TA's task. Creating solution structures and doing some additional stuff for me has been their task. I also have a postgraduate student, Ajinkya Joshi, whose interest was in Akash and continues to be in Akash. And one small regret I have is that the parallel project of distribution of Akash and its implementation in various engineering colleges could not proceed as quickly as our thermo course. And hence I could not integrate it nicely in this course. Otherwise, I was ready with quick quizzes on the clicker application of Akash. And we are playing around with a Scilab based steam tables on Akash. So now it's only a time before that will happen. And once that happens, I think first us teachers will have a perhaps a more young generation friendly environment for teaching. And our students perhaps will take better interest in thermodynamics because perhaps they will think that doing steam tables and thermo solutions on Akash tablet is the in thing to do rather than working with some archaic printed steam tables. So now let me come to some instructions before I pass on to Professor Pathak and maybe some interactions with some centers who may want to say something nice or otherwise for this course. The assignment has been uploaded. The tasks have been informed. All that I have to do is put in some details about what is the final form of the assignment which is expected. Our friend Abhilash tells me that the assignment registration module is already up on Moodle. So please form teams of typically 4 people, but we will accept a few teams of 3 and a few teams of 5. One of them should be elected or selected as the team leader, and the registration is the job of the team leader. Then it will be the duty of the team leader to drive the team and submit the final assignment before the deadline. Some questions have already been asked about the assignment. One question is, can we have teams of our colleagues who stay near us but may not belong to the same center? I think I don't want to do that, because let's take this opportunity to widen your friends and colleague circle. So even if you are not so friendly with people with your centers, I think for this purpose of assignment you should not mind working with them. I have also been told that some people say that we don't have the facility to create a spoken tutorial. I will not accept that, because all you need is a PC or a laptop with a simple microphone attached. I have found out from the local people that a simple microphone doesn't cost you more than 100 or 200 rupees. And it will last long enough till the deadline of this assignment. And you will notice that these days even the simplest of laptops will have a built-in microphone, so you don't really have to buy one. The final thing I want to say is about interaction. This is the second time I am teaching this thermodynamics course to teachers. Last time there were 31 centers, and I am sure we visited each one of these 31 centers twice or thrice during that 10-day workshop. And I almost got used to various people at various places. This time there were 167 centers, and I am sure that there are quite a few centers which we just did not visit or could not visit. And that has left some sort of a lacuna in the implementation of this. But I think when you have a large number of centers and large number of participants, the interaction tends to become more of a one-way interaction rather than a two-way interaction. Of course, we have the Moodle discussion forum, and I hope anybody who wants to continue the interaction should make use of that. Please follow the protocol which I have laid down, that do your homework before asking a question. Large number of questions have been asked, statements have been made which have already been made on Moodle by someone else. So just don't repeat those and clutter up the Moodle discussion forum. And because what we receive on Moodle is just a series of characters, the sentences which you write, I want all of you to put some identity on it by signing off with your name and your affiliation, the college and the place to which you belong. If you do that, I am sure either me or my colleagues, as appropriate, will look it up and provide a rejoinder. The Moodle site of the last time's thermodynamics course is on. This Moodle site for this course will also be on, tentatively, indefinitely. If it is going to be closed down or it is going to be moved to some other place, you will definitely get a notice of that. There has been some criticism of enforcing spoken tutorials, but I want to do that because I think a good set of spoken tutorials will be very good for all of us and also for our students. And hence, if we come up with a reasonably good set of spoken tutorials on various aspects of basic thermodynamics and solution procedures for the typical problems that we have, it will make our life easier and our students' life easier. One participant in the afternoon session today asked me whether I have written a book on thermodynamics or whether I will write a book in thermodynamics. I have not written a book on thermodynamics, and I don't think I have any immediate plans of writing one. However, through these spoken tutorials, we will have some sort of an audio visual book being formed on this site. And if that really becomes a good set, I am sure Professor Patak will make available to us a site on which it will be available to anyone. Because just now, all that is on Moodle is in the open domain, but currently is accessible only by us. That is the teachers, the associated administrators, the coordinators, and the participants. And something good, if anything good which comes out of this, there is no reason why it should be restricted to this and should not be made available to the full student community, at least that community which is interested in thermodynamics. So I think that's enough from me now. Do fill up the assignment registration form as well as the course feedback form. And now control is back to Professor Patak.
Well, since we have agreed that we'll keep this function very short, what I will do is, as a just sort of courtesy sample, I would like to go over to just a couple of remote centers. I have NIT Trichy. Yes, I can see the video of NIT Trichy people. What I will do now is I will go over to a few remote centers quickly and request for a short comment from any participant or the coordinator at that point. So over to you, NIT Trichy.
Good evening, sir. Yeah, it's fine. It is very useful to us.
Hello, please at least let us know your name and which college you come from.
Sir, I am Vaidyanathan from Shivani Institute of Technology in Trichy.
Oh, in Trichy. Okay. Thank you very much. Let me go over to VNIT Nagpur now. Yes, I can see some friends from VNIT Nagpur. May I request someone for a very short comment, please?
So, Professor P.S. Kulkarni, Remote Center Coordinator.
Hello, carry on.
We had 29 registered participants for this. Over to Workshop Coordinator, Dr. Kayamkar.
Good afternoon, sir. We are having 29 participants for this workshop. And 5 participants were from outside station nearby, and for last 10 days they have enjoyed this engineering thermodynamics workshop, particularly the lectures taken by Professor Gaitonde sir, and all the participants are very happy, and definitely they will get benefited through this workshop. And they will teach the concepts given by Professor Gaitonde as far as this thermodynamic subject is concerned. Thank you, sir. Over to you.
Thank you very much. I would like to take this opportunity to also make an announcement which is meaningful only for some of the institutions. You remember I said in my opening remarks for this function that we will be setting up nodal centers within the country from amongst our remote centers. I will be holding a meeting of such prospective nodal center coordinators and their directors on 10th of January, 11th of January in IIT Bombay. We will be sending the invite letters. We are of course finalizing the list. But I can very quickly tell you from amongst the remote centers which are participating in this workshop, NIT Trichy, NIT Warangal, NIT Nagpur, NIT Suratkal, NIT Surat, MANIT Bhopal and College of Engineering Pune. I think these are the centers which you have identified. I don't remember the 8th one, but we'll be soon writing. Yeah. So the request to those remote center coordinators is that one, they should be willing to become now nodal center coordinators with larger responsibilities, and second, they themselves should keep themselves free to visit IIT Bombay on 11th of January, and also advise their directors to come here along with them. Let's continue with our interaction, and let's go to. There is a college in Haryana, and this is Om Institute of Technology and Management, Hisar, Haryana. I can see people from Hisar. May I request someone to make a brief comment, please? Over to you.
Good evening, sir. Myself, Blinder, and I am from Om Institute of Technology and Management, Hisar. It was a great experience for joining the workshop based on engineering thermodynamics. We have learned a lot of things and basic concepts based upon thermodynamics. And I hope IIT Bombay will organize such type of workshop in future. Thank you, sir.
Echo. Thank you very much. There is an institution, Avinashi Lingam University for Women. Let me see. Yes, there are some participants there. May I request someone to make a brief comment, please? Over to you.
Good evening, sir. Good evening, sir.
Good evening. Please go ahead.
So I'm feeling very nice to see you again, sir.
Yes, I'm here.
And I thank you so much for giving us this opportunity, sir. And we carried it very, very well with all your support, sir. And we had 18 participants from our center, and we have been doing it very well with all your tests and interactions went on very well. And we sincerely thank you for all the support given to you, sir.
Well, thank you very much. The real test, madam, is not just attending this workshop and benefiting, for which I compliment you for pestering us no end till we agreed to permit you to become a remote center. But the real test is when our participating colleague teachers go back and complete the assignment that they have given in the same spirit and with the same enthusiasm with which they have participated here. I am sure they will do that. I see that someone else wishes to make a comment. Over to you.
I am the RC coordinator, Lakshmi Priya. And just as we did for the research methodology workshop, we will keep in constant touch with our participants and make sure that they will upload their assignments on time.
Thank you so much. We just go to maybe two or three other institution. There is one St. Peter's Engineering College at Hyderabad, Andhra Pradesh. Let's go over to Hyderabad. Yes, I can see participants there. Over to you for some brief comment, please.
Good evening, sir. My name is Shyamal Rao. I am a remote center coordinator. So this is the first workshop we are conducting here. So it will be successfully we have completed. So but one thing we have required, myself remote center coordinator, is that content of subject you can give and send remote center coordinator's mail also, because it was not related to only you are sending into the workshop coordinators. So how can we can give as a response to other participants and others for remote center coordinator? It will be a request from my side.
I'm sorry, can you repeat the request, because the contents are made available on Moodle, in which even the remote center coordinators are members, I suppose. They're not?
Not, sir. That was not. Oh. They are not given into the remote center coordinators Moodle. That's why, because I...
Oh, I see. Thank you very much for pointing this out. What we'll do is, for all future workshops, we'll also make remote center coordinators as non-editing teachers, so that they will also have access not only to the course material, but everything that is happening in the workshop. Thank you for this suggestion. We will definitely take care of this. Mahendra, may I request you to note it down and pass it to our teams here. I think it's a very useful point that has been made. Let's go over to MANIT Bhopal. They seem to be there. I can see the Bhopal participants. May I request someone to offer a brief comment, please? Over to you.
Hello. Hello, sir.
Yes, we can hear you, ma'am. Please go ahead.
Sir, good afternoon. Very much thanking you on behalf of all the participants for this nice workshop. Sir, here one of the participants, he is very much interested to thank you by his own.
Good afternoon, sir. Hello. Good afternoon, sir. We all thank you to Professor Gaitonde, who taught very well as Indian thermodynamics, and Professor B.C. Puranik too, and Professor Bhandarkar too. And we also request to organize such type of workshop on machine design portion 2. Machine design portion 2.
Okay. Thank you very much, but let me ask you one question before you go away. Please leave the mic with him. One of the questions that I want to ask you is that we are concerned about the number of teachers who will be teaching these different courses. We were concerned about thermodynamics itself. If we embark on machine design teaching, I would like you to answer two questions. One, do you think there will be a large number of faculty members teaching machine design in various engineering colleges in your region? And second, what kind of experimental facilities would be required in order to teach that course, and whether the remote centers will have those facilities? Over to you.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Oh, he is not taking that. Yeah, hello. I think somebody else is answering that question.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. He is workshop coordinator, Dr. Arvind Kumar. He wants to talk.
Yeah, sure.
Good evening, sir. I am thankful to you and your team for organizing such a good workshop, and I am particularly thankful to Professor Gwaitande sir, who has very cool and calm throughout the say about 10 to 12 hours he has been spending. And we get exhausted, but he didn't get exhausted, I can say like that. Regarding the question you have asked regarding the machine design subject, in our college or in our particular region of the university we are having machine design courses in second year as well as in third year. So basically we do some drawing work is involved, some design work is also involved in that, and no particular separate infrastructure is required. I think the way you have organized the thermodynamics workshop, you can also organize machine design workshop. Over to you, sir.
Thank you so much. Very useful information. I will now request Professor Gwaitande to try and enthuse some people to maybe teach that course or consider teaching that course, because we already have some very enthusiastic suggestions from other colleagues in mechanical engineering department and other departments to repeat some of the courses which they had given earlier and which were very well received, such as computational fluid dynamics, for example, and some other courses. I can see some enthusiastic prospective faculty members sitting here, which is good news, but you might want to consider this. Let me go to Bhilai Institute of Technology in Durg. May I request someone to make a brief comment, please? Over to you, Bhilai. Over to you, Durg.
Good evening, sir. This workshop was very nice. In this, we had learned a lot, the new methods, and for me, it was the first experience to have through the internet what we had studied online. That was excellent. Only the problem what we are facing, that most rather I'll say 4 days we had a delay between the lecture and the writing pad, so that has made that particular subjects of no use to us.
What is it?
Otherwise it was very excellent, and we got a good experience of this. Thank you.
Let me ask you one more question, because now I am able to see you very clearly. I am also able to get your audio very clearly, and I suppose there is no further delay. So was there an improvement somewhere in between the course? Can you please comment on that? Over to you.
Actually, what is happening, generally in the first quarter, I will say from up to 11:30 or 11 o'clock, we were most of the time it was just okay. We are getting online everything and it was clear to us. But after that, in the second session before the lunch, that is the problem. Most of the time we were facing that it was so delayed that it is of no use that what we are listening and what we are seeing on that board.
Okay. Thank you very much for pointing this out. But may I point out that unfortunately, the problem is with the internet connection, both the stability of the internet connection and the bandwidth that your service provider is providing to you in actual practice, because everything else is bandwidth related. At our end, I assure you, we have more than 200 megabit per second kind of bandwidth dedicated to this workshop. So you may want to get back to the technical team of the remote center, and who should then question seriously the internet supplier at your end. What may be happening is that as the internet load increases during the daytime, the supplier may be actually supplying you lesser bandwidth than what your contract says. This often happens, and you should definitely cross check with your internet bandwidth provider, because anywhere where the internet bandwidth is perfectly working, there has been no such problem. But thanks for pointing this out. I think with your center, and we will take it up later independently. Thank you so much. We'll go to an institute in Udaipur now. This would be perhaps the last institute which we'll visit. This is NJR Institute of Technology in Udaipur. Yes, I can see their video. May I request someone to make a brief comment, please? Over to you.
Yeah, good evening, Professor. It was very wonderful experience for all the participants here at Udaipur. There are few comments that I want to make. First is one thing that all the participants and we discussed, and that is many a times when professors could not answer the question online, they would easily say that I don't know about this question and I can answer, or I'll answer this later. So that idea actually is very new for many of the faculty members here, and I'm sure that they'll take it positively, because many a times teacher don't know the answer but they'll tell something which is not correct. So I hope that this will be taken very positively by many of the teachers. Thank you.
Thank you.
One more comment.
Yeah, sure.
Good evening, sir. I want to bring your attention to the previous workshop, in fact, about research methodology. Actually, we participated in workshop as M.Tech students, though we were faculties at the institution, and we did not get certificate. So, could anything be done regarding that?
Thank you very much for raising this issue. So let me assure you that if you are a faculty member, all that we need is a letter from your institute, which you can even send by email to our e-outreach program, saying that you were a faculty member at that point in time. And if you are a faculty member, by all means you deserve to get a certificate, and I'll personally ensure that you get a certificate. But we cannot do that without getting a letter from your institute. You see, you yourself registered as an M.Tech student. Now, we did not know whether you are also a faculty member or not. And our system has records showing you as a student. So, if you were also a teacher, you must say that. This is quite likely to happen. There was a time in IIT when we were teachers and we were also pursuing our PhD. So, in that sense, we are students. There is nothing wrong in it. So, that's perfectly fine. Please send us a letter. As regards the first observation, I think it was very well observed by our colleague that people from IIT find it very easy to admit that there is some question which they don't know the answer of. And yes, I also seen, since I also come from a smaller college, that teachers are not willing to say, I don't know. So let me tell you, after 40 years of teaching, I have found that the easiest thing to do for a teacher should be that, look, this is one question, I don't know the answer. I will look back again and get back to you. And quite often in IIT Bombay, I have seen this practice. The student who raises the question and the teacher who can't answer it often work together to find an answer and then announce that answer to the whole class. See, that is how knowledge grows. There is nobody in this world who knows everything perfectly, and there is no student who knows nothing. And that is what is the collaboration. IIT system not only permits and encourages that collaboration, but all of us teachers live with that spirit. We have never absolutely any problem in saying, oh, this is a good question, I have no clue on what this answer is. The only important requirement is that if for every question asked by my students, if I keep saying I don't know, then there is some serious problem with me. But if it happens occasionally, it is very good. In fact, that means that my students are alert and they are asking some serious questions. So, I take this opportunity to compliment you for pointing this out, and I would request, as you have requested your colleagues at your center, not only at your center, but all of us teachers, all 6,000 teachers who are here, please adopt this attitude. I will tell you from personal experience, not only my personal experience, but the personal experience of my colleagues here, that this is an extremely useful attitude. And this enhances both the collaboration, and actually students respect the teachers much more when the teachers are freely admitting something which they do not. So thank you very much for pointing this out. I think with this we have exactly one more minute before 5 o'clock. So because what we had decided is we would like to conclude our common valedictory session at 5 o'clock, so that between 5 to 5.30, locally, the participants and the coordinators could have a photo session. Incidentally, I would like to request that if the participants and the coordinator get a photograph of all the participants together, and upload it on the Moodle. I will ask Abhilash to put up a link. Then we will also have a good photographic memory for all the participants coming here. So let me just go to one remote center here. I have one college in Varnanagar, and that is Tatya Saheb Kore Institute of Engineering and Technology at Varnanagar. I can see the participants in Varnanagar. May I request someone to offer some brief comments, please? Over to you.
Good evening, sir. I am Professor N. S. Sarmapure from the Remote Center of Tatya Saheb Kore Institute of Engineering and Technology, Varnanagar, District Kollapur. Sir, we are very much thankful for giving this opportunity to attend this workshop. All the sessions were very good. The subject thermodynamics was covered very thoroughly. We thank all the professors. All the participants are very much satisfied with the subjects, the depth of coverage of the subject. And we are very much thankful for all this. And also, the one more participant from Bhopal, he suggested that to conduct some of the workshops on machine design. Therefore, here in Shivaji University, we have machine design 1, 2, 3.
Oh.
Actually, the mechanical system design as a machine design 3. So, there are a lot of teachers teaching the subject, and we hope some of the workshops will be conducted on machine design. Sir, our Vice Principal, Dr. S. S. Joshi, would like to mention some points. 1 minute, sir.
Most welcome. Good afternoon, Professor Joshi.
Myself, Dr. S. S. Joshi, Vice Principal of Tatya Saheb Kore Institute of Engineering and Technology. I am very much thankful to you and your team, HRD, for providing this facility. I would like to say that, sir, compared to last two workshops which you have conducted, the audio and video facility which you have provided, there is an improvement. And I hope that in coming future, in other workshops or seminars like this which you are going, certainly there will be a lot more improvement. The lectures conducted by Gayatonde sir and all other his colleagues, we didn't feel it is a distance mode. We feel that they are in front of us and we enjoyed it. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I'm so happy that the audio and video links have improved. I have only one pleasant duty to perform before I announce this session closed. I would request my colleague, Professor Kannan Maudgalya, who is actually the principal investigator of the second phase of this project, and who is also the creator of open or spoken tutorials. So, like me, he is also a passionate person concerned with improving the quality of education in the country. And since he is present here, I would like to request him to say a few concluding words, and then we'll close this.
Thank you, Professor Pathak. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm really delighted that this workshop has gone on extremely well, and the useful suggestions, and also the interest in doing more courses. And one of the things that we want to do, what Professor Pathak said, to establish nodal centers, and through the nodal centers, we could have many courses. May not be possible from IIT if only one institution is doing. There is a limit to which this can be done, but the idea of this nodal center is to elevate other centers or provide the required technology. The faculty members are there. There are good faculty members who know the subject, but the point is, can we also provide them with the know-how of this technology so that they can share what they have? If we do that, then we can do this in a big way. Of course, the director of this mission, Mr. N.K. Sinha, who is a big dreamer, he thinks that all the 500 remote centers that we will establish eventually will also become nodal centers and hubs, and which will disseminate this kind of through this technology disseminate all kinds of things to neighboring schools, other colleges, for example, science, arts, commerce colleges and so on. So, anyway, I am really delighted to see this. I am glad to know that some people pointed out that the audio video quality improved. One of the problems we have from our end is to convince the funding agencies that the course is effective. I have made presentations on behalf of this project to get funding. One of the things that people always asked was, what is the guarantee that the course is effective? What is the guarantee that the people are learning? So, it is important from that point of view. This becomes a serious problem because there are a lot of people. When we have a smaller number of people, then we can be reasonably sure that most people who attend the workshop would be interested. When we scale this up to a larger number, let us say 5000 or even 10,000, what is the guarantee that all the people who participate in this are interested? Unless we can demonstrate that, we will get into problem, because there are questions from audit, questions from third party evaluation, from the ministry, from the auditors who release our funds. So, we have actually promised the government, MHRD, that we will institute procedures to ensure that whoever undergoes this workshop is actually interested. Of course, this will happen through the, you know, if you do this properly, then what will happen is, we will get enough number of people who are motivated participating in the course. We will know that from the marks they score in the tests, we will know whether they submit the assignments on time and things like that. These are important measures that we need to institute immediately. Whatever may be the course, whether it is fluid mechanics course or some other course. Of course, I see that there is a lot of enthusiasm to do many mechanical engineering courses. There are also other subjects. As this project organizers, we would like to make this available for also for other departments, other engineering departments. Now, there are a couple of other things that I want to talk about. One is for computational fluid dynamics, most of you would be using this software called Fluent. We have been promoting an equivalent open source software called OpenFOAM, and as a matter of fact, there is a new faculty member in the mechanical engineering department by name Shiva. So, Professor Shiva has been using OpenFOAM for many years, 7-8 years, and he is the local expert. We have also created spoken tutorials on OpenFOAM, and those are available on our web page, spoken-tutorial.org. All of those are available. In case anybody wants to organize these workshops, please send a note in Moodle. Please note that these workshops are conducted through our events team. We will not come in person. Immediately people start responding, we want to organize a 2-day workshop. No, we are not doing any of those. These workshops can be done in 2 hours, and whoever is interested can learn on their own. So, as the methodology evolves, as our technology improves, we will also be introducing methods that will allow interested people to learn on their own, that we will facilitate learning, but then the learning has to happen by you directly. Okay? And of course, Scilab is another thing that we have been promoting quite a bit. For OpenFOAM, you need to know C and C++. We also have spoken tutorials on C and C++, which you may want your students to know anyway, so that they can clear the IT entrance exams of companies like Infosys, TCS and so on. So, the students also can get good jobs, IT jobs. So, it has been a great experience working on this project, and so in case there are any mistakes, we are just like you, we are also learning, and we are improving our mistakes, and our mistakes actually help us improve. So do send us feedback, and I want to congratulate all of you for having gone through this workshop successfully. In fact, I was really delighted to see that even after 10 days at 5 o'clock on a Friday evening, there are quite a few people in far corners of the country. So I wish you all the best. Jai Hind.
Once again, thank you very much, and thank you all.